B-Pod Studios.
Get ready. It's time now for Solek and Bertrand. Brought to you by BetMGM, the king of sportsbooks on 98.5 The Sports Hub.
You know, it's hard to be good for that long. You know, I read something like if this is Patrick Mahomes' sixth straight AFC championship game. Like, that's on LeBron level. You know what I mean? If you think about that, only person go to the conference finals more than Patrick Mahomes is LeBron James. So it's going to be a great game, man. But I think it ultimately comes down to which defense can make a stop when other team has, you know, the ball last.
It's Terrell Suggs forgetting a guy named Tom Brady. Conveniently forgetting a guy named Tom Brady.
It's on purpose.
Yeah, no kidding.
And
it's
you
on
want
purpose.
To root for that.
Yeah. That's your
yeah.
team.
Yeah.
Those
yeah. And I've seen the video, him and Ray Lewis going at it on the sidelines because they're talking about this one's different. We got to get this guy because this is Brady. They knew it. They knew it then when he played. That's why Suggs is always trying to get in his face. And Brady would give it right back to him. Boy, I wonder if Mahomes gets there this year and wins it. If he does. I don't think he's going to because I'm rooting for Baltimore. What if this one would mean more because you go through Buffalo, you're on the road first time ever, and you go through the number one seed in Baltimore. Then you go out to Vegas, and then you beat the number one seed there in San Fran if they advance. Like, this one could be the most meaningful as opposed to the other two loaded roster ones and the loss he had to Brady. Now, I said that yesterday, and I said, yeah, he's nipping at his heels. He can't be nipping at his heels. Yeah. He can because this is the number one threat right now. He's a threat. That's kind of nipping at your heels. He's got a long way to go. I said it yesterday, but that didn't get added to the story. Interesting, Tyler. How it's only halftime, and I said, go get your orange slices. Yeah, if he gets one more. Say he does win this one. He's only halfway to Brady. He's got a long way to go. But the pace he is on. Six straight titles, AFC title games. Already broke the Brady Gronk record. Those guys were together longer than him and Travis. He's on his way. And that means he's on his heels. It's not anybody else. There's no other threat. He's the threat. And the pace continues. He's in it again. And he's getting points on the road. Scary thing to do. Wonder who we're going to take. Ooh, their pick'ems on Friday. Beetle, you win your game Friday?
I did.
Week? Yeah.
14-3 now on the year. I
lost mine. It went over, didn't it? Damn it. That freaking Tampa Detroit game went over.
14.
I took
three.
The under.
Yeah. I might just take whoever you take.
That's not how it works.
Double up. Pound it.
Not quite how it works.
I know.
Yeah. It's okay. You can actually bet your actual money on whatever I take, whatever I pick.
Suggs is an idiot, though, man.
Oh, that's your team, though. Those are your guys.
No. They were on that team.
How about those Ravens? He's rooting for the Ravens
what?
This weekend.
What, McCone?
I'm with Zoe. I'm rooting for the Ravens,
you would
too.
Be, McCone.
Yes.
Of course he
you
is.
You would
Attaboy.
Be.
You got nothing else to root for except Brady in the past.
Yeah, who do you hate on the Ravens? Come on.
Don't let Mahomes get his third.
I want Ravens 49ers. I want the two best teams. Give me one versus one. Be a fun Super Bowl week.
Did Lamar leapfrog Josh Allen in the whole Brady, Manning, Mahomes, Allen conversation?
What? What do you mean?
Is it now Mahomes Jackson?
No.
What if he wins on Sunday?
How does he win? Do you have a 40-yarder he takes in for the game winner? Like with his legs? Does he hit lively or is it likely? It's likely. I always screw that up, the tight end. Does he hit him on two scores? Threads it? Maybe he's eight flyers on a deep one? I don't know. Tell me how he wins the game. Like defense goes out there and picks off Mahomes three times. I'd say no. It just seems like there's just so much pressure, more pressure on Josh Allen. And you're going to nitpick everything that he does, like the fumble. Why are you throwing it there, second and third down? Why don't you hit the check down? All that stuff. The potential pick six he almost had. And people go back with that magnifying glass, get under there, where I don't think Lamar's been in that spot enough to where it's been Mahomes and Allen. That's why we compared like Brady and Manning. No, Lamar needs this, though. Lamar needs this to get him in the conversation. Because he kind of gets left out of the conversation. Because they win differently. You know, they use a three tight end offense a lot. But he's still able to be very productive out of it with the throw. So he's so damn dangerous with his legs.
You got Lamar Jackson versus Mahomes. You had Josh Allen last week. Joe Burrow's still hurt. We're just talking about Herbert with a new head coach.
Burrow being hurt screwed this whole thing up a little bit.
Isn't this kind of why you have to go quarterback if you're the Patriots, though, and this is the landscape of the AFC moving forward? You're going up against all these guys. Like, don't you have to have a quarterback that can compete somewhat with some of these players that we're talking about? Whether it's Jackson, Mahomes, Josh Allen, Joe Burrow when he comes back.
Yeah. You definitely need a quarterback, no doubt about it. You need a lot of other things, too, to make that quarterback successful quickly. How patient are you? You know, ready for a 3 to 4 year build? Or you want a 2 year build? Like, what do you want? Maybe they feel like you get there quicker with a quarterback.
Faster.
It's all up to them.
Typically better.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I would approach it.
Burn that cash.
Yeah. Burn that cash. Yes. I would agree with that. Burn the cash, as Gerard Mayo would tell you that they're about to do. Josh in North Attleboro in the Baseball Hall of Fame. Hi, Josh.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey.
How are you?
What's up?
Good.
Just a quick question. I just want to chime in on the MLB Hall of Fame. So with everything that's been going on, and by the way, 99% for Beltre, yeah, great, great player, but damn, that's like Griffey Jeter stuff. I don't believe that.
Strong.
What about back in the day, like, you have all the steroid era, but you also have guys that won't get in, like Clemens, Bonds. We all get that. But if you look at their careers before they started that, it was already Hall of Fame career. And I don't know how, like, you guys feel about that kind of stuff. I mean, I know they want to put an asterisk next to steroid players, but it's kind of getting ridiculous, I think.
Yeah, I would put all those guys in.
Yeah.
I'd even put Manny and A-Rod in. And they were abusive and over the top with their level of PED use. They just couldn't quit the damn things.
And the Barry Bonds that I know and love is not the skinny Barry Bonds.
Yeah, no, I
like, need the yoked out one.
I like the roided out one, which was not all of a sudden something he discovered in 1998, by the way. Okay? That head started growing much earlier in the 90s than anyone wants to admit.
Eric Gagne versus Barry Bonds, though, that's when baseball is baseball.
That's the good old days.
Come on.
That's the good stuff. Matt's in Rhode Island. Hey, Matt.
How are you doing, guys?
Good.
Hey, Beetle, there's no better adjective that anyone has ever said describing John Henry as lurking, by the way. That's why you make the big bucks, buddy. But I was just thinking, Joe Murray brought it up, yeah. As far as offensive coordinator, like when you got a guy like Jaden Daniels compared to the guy from North Carolina, I mean, don't you have to account for that? Jaden Daniels especially, like, designing an offense around him? Thanks, guys.
Yeah, I could see that. Jaden Daniels makes a better fit for running, some of these newer concepts. You want to run an RPO, who you want to run it with? Well, Jaden Daniels seems to be a guy who could fit that pretty damn well.
Mm-hmm.
You could definitely maybe attract a certain type of candidate for OC if you know you're getting Jaden Daniels. Excuse me. Agree?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just wish they'd sort of speed up the process offensively. Just, we'd be doing this for 3 weeks.
It's only been a week. They just named their...
Feels like it's been four.
It hasn't even been a week since they named Gerard
Mayo.
Doesn't
it feel like it's been four? Like, it's I got to keep reminding myself. We were just down there Wednesday for Mayo's press.
Yeah, tomorrow will be a week.
Wow.
Yes.
Feels like forever.
You're getting very impatient.
Yeah, what do you want me to do? Go Pats.
617-779.
I feel like I'm on a flight to Newark, New York, and we're just circling.
Get more of your calls coming up next. Stay tuned.
Let's go.
In the middle of your day, they're in the middle of Boston sports. Solak and Bertrand on the Sports Hub.
617-779-0985, the phone number for you. Let's get back to some of your calls. Dan in Colorado on Bill Belichick not having a job yet. Hi, Dan.
Hey, guys. I'm actually not surprised Bill Belichick doesn't have a job yet, because as an HR professional, I can tell you one of the most important steps of the recruitment and onboarding process is an accurate reference assessment. And we all know who Bill Belichick's main reference would be. And it makes me wonder, what kind of reference do you think Robert Kraft is leaving for Bill Belichick around the league right now to keep him out of a job?
I don't think that matters. I don't think that matters one bit. If you're an owner with half a brain in this league, you study the league. You know the league. You see Bill in his press conferences. It's been going on for 24 years. You know how good Tom Brady was. My question would be, when Bill came in, what happened post-Tom Brady? I don't need to know the Brady years. I know about the Patriot way. I know about the players you've had. I know your Hall of Famers. I know Vinatieri was a good kicker. You know, got in Randy Moss. Won with Vrabel and that loaded defense back in the day. And Ty Law. Yeah, we get all that. What happened since 2019? Tell me, what was the approach? Team building aspect, draft aspect. What happened on the free agents you brought in? Who told you to bring those guys in? Who did the studying for you? Are you going to bring these guys along? Who's your play caller? Who's your defensive play caller? All good questions, right? I don't think me as an owner would have to look at a reference from Mr. Kraft or study HR. We know Bill tells you he's miserable to work for. Players tell you that. Coaches tell you that. But they tell you they come out of there a better person and a better player after it, because you become a winner. And you're thankful for it when you're done, not while you're in it. But that would be my questions to Bill. What happened since 2019? What changed?
Would you hire him right now if you're an owner?
If I had a quarterback, yes. If I was the Cowboys or the Bills and I wanted to get over the hump, 100%. If I had the roster in place and I thought we were competitive enough to win a Super Bowl, yes.
Bill was gone prior to that Dallas game.
If you're Arthur Blank, are you hiring Bill Belichick? I'm not.
No.
That's not the route I'm going to take.
Should be going after Vrabel.
Yeah, because there's more shelf life there and longevity.
Yeah, I don't think you're close. Yeah.
I don't think they're close. I think Bill does make sense for a quick marriage in a place like Dallas to get a team over the hump that underachieved.
If I was Jerry Jones, I would have fired him and hired Bill. That would have been done.
Like, I'm not even sure the Chargers meet that threshold. I could see why they would want him there because they think they have the pieces in place and they have the quarterback.
No interest there, huh?
But I would not hire
him. From which side?
Hire Arthur Blank. I'm not hiring Bill Belichick. We're not close. We don't have the quarterback. We've got pieces that we need to develop and bring in, and I'm not doing it. I don't think he's a good fit for Atlanta.
So who's left?
If you're the Commanders, would you want him?
No.
No, it's a bottom-up rebuild, like top to bottom. You've got to start over.
So who had the report? It was Schefter, right? That there's two to three more teams interested. That it's picked up. That was the beginning of the week, right? And one with the head coach. I don't know who they'd be. Is it Carolina? I feel like they've thrown their hat in this thing.
And as we say that, there's this. According to The Athletic's Josh Kendall, Bill Belichick's candidacy to be the next head coach of the Atlanta Falcons has, quote, lost momentum over the last week.
Wow. So something happened since second interview, which took place last Friday. So that last Friday one was the one he put in on the private jet. They had dinner in Atlanta, right? Trying to keep them all together here.
Maybe once they get to the nitty gritty, you're like, I don't know if this is lining
here,
up.
Here are my demands, right?
Yeah.
Mike Vrabel is expected to interview for the job this week. Lost momentum.
So Bill legitimately might not be coaching next year then.
He may not be coaching.
Wow.
Again, news
not
today.
By, not by his own choice.
Jim Harbaugh is likely going to land with the Chargers. He's wrapping up a deal to become the Chargers head coach. The Raiders have settled in on their head coach, keeping their interim coach. The Titans will bring on, I so badly want to call him Bo Callahan.
Call him that, then. Until he proves otherwise, he's Bo Callahan.
So the open jobs.
No one went to his birthday party.
Are Carolina, Atlanta, Washington, Seattle.
I'm shocked the Raiders didn't make a run at him.
And I don't think Seattle is going to be one of the options for him.
Oh.
I don't think the Commanders will be an option. Carolina?
So it's Carolina, Seattle. He's not following Pete to Seattle.
No.
No.
I'm shocked Vegas didn't make a run. I am.
Based on the history of the father, the appreciation for that franchise, and just the boob-headed owner that he is now.
Well, I don't think they wanted to run into a situation where Bill Belichick comes into a roster that had just revolted on one of his disciples and Josh McDaniels.
It's another bad
look. And Max Crosby said, I will demand a trade if we swap out Antonio Pierce. That's what he said he was going to do. Yeah. I'm out of here. I won't play for this franchise anymore. You want to deal with that disaster? No.
No.
So I'm not totally surprised by that.
Who do you think pulled out in Atlanta? You think it was Bill, or you think it's at the Falcons?
I think it's the Falcons. I think they're doing a thorough process, so they may have.
It's been hard pressed by them for a week, and then all of a sudden they requested all these new candidates to interview, which was odd. Because as of last Friday, to Diana Rossini's report, and who's the other one?
Justine Anderson.
Yeah, Justine Anderson. Thank you. That a deal was imminent, and it was getting things were heating up.
Wonder who that came.
We talked about it wouldn't be announced out of straight respect for the league, allow the divisional round to happen, then announce it on Monday. That's where we left this on Friday. And now here we are, 3 work days later, saying things have cooled down.
Which it seems like they
have. If they were in love with Bill Belichick, they would have hired him by now.
Yeah.
Correct.
Yep.
I agree.
Jason's on the Cape. Hi, Jason.
Jason, guys, how you doing?
Good.
Hey. How are we doing today?
Good.
I was just listening in and great stuff today. And, you know, I'm thinking that a lot of these owners really, I mean, the one key question they might have is why and who was responsible for getting rid of Tom Brady? How do you let Tom Brady leave the organization?
Yeah, right.
That's what he came up with today.
Yeah, well, that's kind of what I said. What happened post Brady? What transpired these 3 years, these 4 years, to get to the point where you're no longer there?
How'd you get rid of Tom Brady? Tell us. We need to do the same to Desmond Ridder.
How did you have the balls to do that? I want to make these decisions, but I just don't have the guts to do it. How do you do that? Just tell me how you do it.
How do you do it?
I don't think there's any backdoor smear campaign or someone giving you bad reports or, like, you need to go to anybody else for a report on him. Yeah. Give me a break. If you don't know about him by now, then you got problems.
Nick in Plymouth. Hey, Nick.
Hey, guys. I just want to ask about the Bedard report. Who do you trust more? Somebody who is anonymous with Bedard saying that the whole team is having issues or multiple teammates? Or Trent Brown, who's been very vocal lately, basically defended Mac and said that the offensive line was not equipped, and even went after the whole idea that Patricia was a horrible hire and put him into a horrible spot too.
What's closer to the truth? Mac Jones is not well-liked by teammates or well-liked by teammates?
What do your eyes tell you?
That he doesn't have a good relationship with a lot of his teammates.
I don't know that. I'm not reporting that, but that's the way it seems to me. You don't even have a relationship with the quarterback that you're in the room with all day. That's non-existent. They don't look at each other. I don't know how you work like that. You're like you and me doing a show, but I never speak to you. I just do this all day.
We have seen that before.
I've done that.
I think that's happened.
His name was Kevin Winter. And I held up a paper.
Oh, we got to go back that far.
Yeah.
Oh.
Just held up like this.
Do this. Do the show like this. Just hold up a paper. Wow. Read the paper.
Kenan,
how you doing?
I didn't know we were in for a Kevin Winter take.
Oh, you asked me.
Wow.
What's up, Kev? Shut up. Jesus. Okay, keep talking.
I heard he's interviewing for the third chair.
Oh, that didn't happen.
No? You cross him off our list?
You want to do this now?
Why? What are we doing?
Go through the candidates?
Hey, careful. The Herald might turn this into a story.
Oh, God, I know. Shh, don't say it.
Don't even want to say anything.
Joking.
Rick's in there getting nervous. Don't do it.
I'll do a list. I think that'd be a good segment for tomorrow.
Are things heating up or not heating up?
He could do a web post.
Yeah. Are you back in tomorrow?
No.
No?
Nope.
Man, no one stays for more than a day.
Wow, it's crazy. We keep people on edge.
They're in and out.
Tomorrow's TBD right now.
It's a real carousel. We had someone call out sick for tomorrow. I can't read lips. I don't know what you're saying.
I can't read
over
lips
there.
Either. I'm the worst lip reader. My wife goes nuts. She'll be at dinner. Like.
Hey, by the end of the week, Bill Belichick might be applying for the job. You know, he's out of work.
Hey guys, what's up? Sports Hub headlines. Hold on a second. Brought to you by. Yeah. Who's this guy?
Rapid flow. Sewer and drain cleaning.
All right. Next headlines. Half an hour. Yeah. On to the next one.
We'll on to the next headline. We're on to the 2 p.m. headlines.
Yeah.
Get him in the booth with Brady.
Oh,
get him in the booth with
Brady. It'd be great. It'd be great.
Fake.
Put those two on any breakdown show, anything. They're good together.
Respect. Bill Belichick for Beadle and Zoe.
Watch the top 100 again, where they were like, things were at its worst. And they sat there and talked and laughed and joked.
I'll tell you what. I'll pick him up on the way in. We can carpool together.
I could.
We live near each other. Both T-Bone and I go through sort of his neck of the woods on the way in.
Let's all carpool.
What?
You don't know where he is.
Oh, I know where he is. No, that's still got... No.
I don't know.
No.
Is it all right? Let's send McCollum to pick him up. He'd get him nervous. He'd be sweating his armpits.
Oh, my God, yeah. No.
You'd be pitted out.
Sweating. Dripping up
drenched.
Drenched. Shaking the driver.
So,
why you
coach,
so nervous?
What do you want to listen to on the radio?
Put the 50s on, 60s, huh?
Country guy? No.
No. Wow. You like Luke Combs?
Bon Jovi. Let's put some Jersey rock on.
Oh, you're a big 70s on 7 guy. All right, we can do that.
Let's put a Creedence Clearwater Revival. Okay. A little bit.
Coach, don't drink it in the Focus. Sorry. Clean that up.
Ford Focus. Nice.
Headlines now on McCone. We'll be right back.
This ain't a song for the broken heart.
Scott Solak. Mark Bertrand. Solak and Bertrand. 98.5 The Sports Hub.
He's not one dead or alive. Bill Belichick.
McCone, you play this for your girlfriend? You wear chaps? Like, yeah, I'm a cowboy.
No.
You think he's a good passenger? Or you think he's... Just get off here and take the back.
Watch you. What are you going this way for?
What are you going this way for?
I mean, wouldn't you plan the route out? Yeah. Wow, for traffic. You know? I mean,
you guys want anything? I'm ordering ahead at Starbucks.
I don't think he's carrying a road trip. I think that's a tough conversation.
You know.
He's definitely not a Starbucks guy either.
Yeah. Doesn't drink coffee.
All
does
natural?
Not drink coffee.
He doesn't drink coffee.
Floored by it. Floored by the amount of time that guy spends in the office.
Yeah.
Really? Coffee with the coach? He doesn't drink coffee?
Doesn't drink coffee. I could have coffee with the coach. Get it?
Are you truly having coffee with someone if they're not drinking coffee?
Wait a second. You guys aren't actually having coffee?
No, we're talking, you dumbass. Sponsored by the coffee people.
Oh.
When Cheryl submitted her question online,
Westwood,
she thought there was coffee involved, while the rest of us thought she was real.
Could have come up a better name, huh?
It's one of those towns out there by Route 1. Westwood.
Tim's in Plymouth. What's up, Tim?
Hey, so I just wanted to talk about the fact that not just the Patriots, but everyone had a chance to sign Lamar Jackson this offseason, but the Patriots were one of the front runners to do it. And the ownership is too cheap. And if Belichick and Lamar were together this year, they might not make an AFC championship, but they're probably making the playoff, and he probably wouldn't have lost his job. So I just feel like no one really talks about it, but the MVP was a free agent this year.
You wouldn't have a first-round pick this year or next year.
Doesn't matter. Who cares? You're still going to be a championship contender the next 4 years. Why do you care about a first-round pick?
Have you seen the state of the team?
Okay.
So you're just going to plug him in, and they're going to be what?
What's different between the Patriots team and the Ravens?
They have three stud tight ends.
Really?
They can lose their tight ends. They have Zay Flowers, who's a first-round pick.
And Mark Andrews. I mean, Mark Andrews is better,
take Mark Andrews.
Like, not a big difference.
Well, they lost him to an injury. Broke his leg.
Exactly.
He's coming back, right. How about that pick they nailed in the fourth round? I
don't have an argument against it. Because the Patriots have the third overall pick, and I'm advocating for them to draft a quarterback, fully understanding that that quarterback may be a bust. So you're already spending one highly coveted top pick on a quarterback. You're telling me you wouldn't spend two of those to know that it's a guy capable of winning the league's MVP award?
You think they ever entertained that? Was that an owner's decision or a coach's decision?
My guess would be it was a coach's decision.
Would you rather
But just in theory, would that have been worth it for a team to do it? I think so. If you're without the quarterback piece and you can get one that's that good and established, yeah.
I think Billy, based on how he called it in Houston with a mobile quarterback and Deshaun Watson and how he can move and throw on the run, he'd call a different game. He'd be calling a different game. No doubt about it.
Zoe talked about it earlier. Look at the haul that the Niners gave up for Trey Lance, an unproven guy.
Yeah.
Couldn't play at all. You lost all those picks. Why not cash him in for a guy that you know can play? Not bad.
I also think you have to call into question just the league in general not willing to mess with other teams' players.
Yeah, they could have matched it. Maybe right? It's one of those things like, we're franchising. Guy. Don't come after my franchise player. Plus, Baltimore could have matched
it. It's called collusion.
Imagine if you did that. Put the contract together, offered it, and Baltimore matched it.
Oh, well, then at least you gave it a try.
Yeah.
But the question is not that question is not exclusive to the Patriots. You can ask that of other teams and why they didn't try and do that.
Yep.
It's not just a Patriots related question. Adam's in Rhode Island. Adam.
Hey, what's up, guys? Yeah, if we made the offer to Lamar and then the Ravens matched it, well, we would have killed Max Psyche, huh? Not. Guys, would you take
not
Jaden Daniels?
Not.
Would you take Jaden Daniels at 3 or take Harrison at 3 and then make a trade for Fields at like a third or fourth round pick?
B.
You take Harrison and Fields.
Mm-hmm.
I thought Fields was going for the 8th overall.
Yeah, what happened to that one? So
I didn't say that. That's what Mel Kiper said.
You told us he's going for a big-time
pick. My mother said.
I don't think he's going for a fourth
rounder.
Your mother said.
Your mother.
I think he's going to get more than a fourth rounder.
Yeah. I think he will, too.
Should the Bears consider trading out of one?
Mm-hmm.
I know I wouldn't if I were them, but the way you think about this,
I think it's in play because they didn't go after Cliff Kingsbury. Like they went after him, had him in for an interview, but they went in a different direction. It's unusual. Keep that thing rolling, right, Caleb? We're bringing in your offensive coordinator, your play caller, the guy that had the play calls for Johnny Football, the guy that called plays for Patrick Mahomes. Cliff did that for all those guys. So I give that guy a call.
Bill's in East Hampton. Hey, Bill.
Hey, how are you, guys?
Hey, Billy.
So got a question for you. Did the Falcons lose interest in Belichick because he was going to bring in Judge and Patricia, which we already know doesn't work?
Yeah, I think that could definitely have been a part of it. I was talking about that yesterday. You go in and talk with Arthur Blank. Well, what are you going to build here? What's this going to look like? Well, it's going to be me and Matt Patricia and Joe Judge and Josh McDaniels. Then maybe the light goes on like, wait, what? You know what, Bill? We really like you, but on second thought, we're good. But all of a sudden, he's just reassembling the staff.
Yeah.
Bill Bobos unite. You know, like, what? I don't know about that. I'm actually having second thoughts.
Is Brady coming?
Yes. That's what he asked yesterday. All right, so is Tom Brady coming as well? That'd be my question. Al's at Plymouth. Hey, Al.
Hey guys, how you doing? I'm just going to give you guys a hypothetical question here. If Mayo wasn't hired as the head coach and both Vrabel and Harbaugh were both unavailable as well, who would you rather have as the head coach out of the following three candidates?
Right.
Pete Carroll, Josh McDaniels, or the maid who went in my hotel room and saw me getting out of the tub without any clothes on?
Yes! Yes, that one! More, please!
Did you bolt your door like when you get in? How do you?
They set that up well.
They did. Excellent. Well delivered.
I was waiting to hear who the third not such great option
was. You're like, well, who is this? Yeah.
Or the maid. Oh, God.
The maid.
And there she is again. Nathan in Rhode Island. Hi, Nathan.
Hi. So I have a hypothetical.
More hypothetical.
If we do Marvis Harrison Jr. at three, take out Joe Flacco 2 years contract.
Joe
and
Flacco?
Then you do. I don't know. He looked good this year, but then have like take out McCarthy game? Or something, like the second round, then up your O line, and then go out and get Mike Evans.
You know what? I take it back. I'd rather have Mac Jones back. I'd like to.
I would too.
I'd like to return back to what we were talking about earlier when I said,
"Oh, those picks
I want
are
nothing
so
to
bad.
Do with Mac Jones. It's good for everybody to break up
those pick sixes."
Oh. If you're offering me Joe Flacco and J.J. McCarthy, I'll take Mac Jones. I would take Mac Jones over J.J. McCarthy.
I would too. I don't see the sex appeal of J.J. McCarthy anywhere. I don't get it.
I don't quite get it.
What's the last big game you saw him play? Like, other than managing the game, like, see any highlight tapes of him? Threading the needle? Out of spread? Going gun
Mac
down 14?
Mac Jones' college work was far more impressive
than
J.J. McCarthy. Oh, my God.
We fell in love with it.
Yeah.
Fell in love with this Alabama tape. God. McCarthy, very high schoolish. It's the way I equate it. Feels like you're looking like it. Harbaugh teams always have done that. Same thing when Andrew Luck was at Stanford. I'm not comparing him to Luck. I'm just saying they ran a power eye, two tight end offense. It was very high school like.
He was better with quarterbacks in the pros than he was.
He was better with quarterbacks in the pros than he is.
That's what should scare you about Justin Herbert.
Tom is in Norfolk today on the draft. Hey, Tom.
Hey, guys. So I'm kind of with Zoe. The Patriots cannot draft receivers to save their life. And you have one sitting there at three that's like a complete bullseye, can't miss. Even though they need a quarterback, I think you have to take Harrison.
I want them to fall in love with the quarterback. Not just say, boy, all three are great. I'd take any one of them. That doesn't work. You got to have a vision. You got to say, ooh, I could see us doing something with this guy. I'd love our first down package out of trips. I'd love our third down package out of two tights. We can keep him off balance. Something. Fall in love with one guy. Go get him. If he's there at three, take him. Take him. Don't just say, we took him to take him. I don't want that. Then you go get Harrison or trade back. I don't see, but you can't trade back. You're sitting there at three and been there since 93, 94. You know, No. Take the pick. Pick somebody there. Then trade to get back in. I like to see that. I like to see you get back in the
trade
bottom of the first.
Trade back up. Oh, I like that.
I like to see a take three and then let's get, hey, we got some picks there. Let's move back up into the bottom of the first. Do it.
Let's get to today's takeaways. They are next.
Come.
Now, Sports Talk for your workday.
If you want to dream big.
Zolak and Bertrand.
Hey, can I touch that thing? Sure. It's a stanchion. Yeah, go ahead.
On 98.5, the Sports Hub.
All right, it's time for today's takeaway brought to you by Awaken 180 Weight Loss. Take away your excess weight loss for life. Nine locations to choose from. Awaken180weightloss.com, official weight loss program of the Boston Red Sox.
Takeaway today is revisiting Randy Johnson's Hall of Fame speech. Oh, God. One of the best.
I mean, it's a wonder he doesn't do pregame desk stuff, you know. MLB Network or something, or TNT, you know, like something like that.
How about that drive-in?
2007, 2008. In 2009, I finished my career.
It's amazing Fox doesn't put him on like with A-Rod and Poffy, you know?
In San Francisco.
I remember coming in the next day, I'm like, did you guys watch any of the Hall of Fame induction? Did you see Randy Johnson's speech?
If we went,
did anyone catch this?
If we went all the way to Arizona, I mean, all the way to Vegas to do Radio Row this year, and the only guest that we would be guaranteed to have was Randy Johnson, I would say no.
The only interview we could get that was, we got to Randy Johnson.
You want him? No. Nope. No.
My journey in baseball lasted 44 years.
Nobody proofread that with him? Like,
I started when I was 7 years old.
Probably could have tightened it up a little bit.
You didn't sit down with the wife or brother or something or mentor. Say, hey, what do you think of this speech?
Heartfelt emotion throughout.
Really got the gist of, like, his life, you know? Like, what made him tick?
Legendary.
Then I was part of a trade from Montreal to Seattle.
Oh, is that right?
Sequential. I mean, his life
is
very
sequential.
It's a sequence to it.
Who was in that trade?
That would bring Mark Langston from Seattle to Montreal, and myself, Brian Holman, and Gene Harris to Seattle.
Oh, good.
Per Baseball Reference.
Just give me Ricky Henderson's. That's all I need. His mama knows best. He is the greatest of all time.
As my time finished up in Seattle, I went to Houston for 2 months.
It's a hell of a 2 months, man.
Wild times.
Good times. How much barbecue you eat during those 2 months? One of the greatest baseball pitchers of all time. It's guys like that that make baseball boring. No electricity whatsoever to your career.
And the 99% of voters that put in Adrian Beltre.
I'm pretty sure we didn't care about his personality when he was on the mound.
Not when he was on the mound. Big throwing lefty.
Hard. By the way, Maz was one of the guys who didn't vote for Beltre, apparently. It's Maz and Ballou on an island together.
He didn't vote for Manny
either.
No Beltre
vote. No Beltre vote.
Yeah. No steroid votes.
Which, Maz's ballot, thumbs up or thumbs down, Maz, is Manny and A-Rod and that's it? Was that your ballot? I don't know.
Yes.
Yeah, I think it was.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
That's the right take.
Love it. Yeah. Best ballot anyone submitted this year.
A baseball purist.
A Manny A-Rod ballot.
Yeah.
That's a ticket right there.
It's like the old guys need to die off. It's weird. Like, you need to phase out before you
shaking
forget
his head,
what it is.
I don't know why. I'm on board with his ballot. Love his ballot. That's like taking a stand. I'm not voting for all these other clowns until we can all admit that these two guys are Hall of Famers.
No Manny, no Todd Helton.
That to me is a hill worth dying on. Die on that hill.
99%.
99% for Adrian Beltre. Like, first we can't. There's not even a conversation anymore about that player.
No.
There's no debate over whether or not he's a Hall of Famer. He's 99% of ballots, first year lock.
It's almost like we got to find the one person that didn't vote for him. We got to say, are you sure?
It's over.
It's over.
It's over.
Yeah.
It's over. Nothing you can do. The warheads and stat geeks and longevity freaks have all won out.
Shaughnessy's.
No Manny. No A-Rod.
Manny and A-Rod. Great ballot. Put him in. It's over. It's all over.
Yeah.
Get it. It was good.
You won't go back out.
I don't need to.
Nope. You saw the best. You saw the greatest.
Would you have even feared a 3-4 of Harold Baines and Adrian Beltre?
Harold Baines and Beltre on the same team.
Winning 76 games.
Yeah. Third place finish. No doubt. Bye.